Merry Christmas to each and everyone. Christmas brings a universal message of peace and love, good wishes and good tidings for all. And so I'd like to focus on the universal aspects of Christmas. And I know that Christmas is a family time, and every festival across the world at all the different times of year when we have celebrations, it's a time for family to come together. It's a very beautiful reminder that the foundation of civilization and human life is very much the family unit. And so the closer the links we have with family members, of course with our parents, but also our brothers and sisters and further, however far we want to extend it till we include the entire human race, the entire family of humanity. It's a time to celebrate that and to be able to experience the love and good wishes in our hearts for each and every individual of that family. So what does Christmas mean to me? I've done the shopping, maybe I've done the cooking, maybe I've put up all the decorations and all of that is done. But maybe now I can focus on the most important message, and that is the sacred message of Christmas. And the message of pure love. Love for God, God's love for us, so that God is able to send us a Savior. God is able to send us messengers, angels who are able to give us a message, a signal to connect with the divine and to be able to experience inner peace once again. So let's look at all of these traditions. Apart from family, yes, that spirit of generosity and being able to give. Well, how does that come about? Let's look at the one who is truly the father and mother of the whole of the world, and that is God the Supreme. So maybe through the rest of the year, I don't have space or time to think about God. Maybe Christmas Eve, when it's a time which is quiet and silent, maybe that's a time when my thoughts of love can turn to God. And in return, I'll feel the abundance of the treasures that God wants to give me. Love and joy and truth and prosperity on all levels. A state of perfection within human life. This is truly God's wish for all of us. Can I do that? Yes, if my heart is open to receiving God's love, I can be an instrument. I can be like those angels that have been depicted in history. I can make sure that I stay up above the daily toil and troubles that come my way in the physical dimension. And being up above in company with God, I can look down on what's going on the earth, on this planet, and being up above, I can see that the most important thing that the world needs is love. It's not a cliche, it's actually a reality. We've forgotten about love, we've forgotten about the things of the heart, and we focus so much on external things. So Christmas is truly a reminder to turn within and find that space of love, in which I can feel God's love for me, but also I can be open and generous and share that love with each and every human being. They say that love thy neighbor as you would love yourself. In fact, it's the first commandment. How much do I love myself? Let me be able to go deep inside and recognize my own value, my own self-worth, have esteem and dignity within myself. And then, with love in my eyes, I can look at each one of my neighbors and see the value of each one, see them with the respect that they deserve, so that then I uphold their dignity also. Having nothing but good wishes in my heart is the message of Christmas. Let me share good wishes for all. And I can only do that if I truly clean out my heart and let my heart be filled with nothing but goodness and truth and beauty. And then, yes, a heart that's filled with goodness is able to send out good tidings, is able to send out good wishes for every person on the human planet. So this Christmas, let it be a little bit different. Yes, let me give gifts that are physical and external, they're valuable. But more than that, let me share the gifts of the soul, the gifts of the heart, the gift of love, and also the gift of peace. Every soul is crying out for peace, whether they show it or they don't. Maybe it's an inner crying rather than an external one. But when is it that we have a moment of peace for ourselves? It's rare, isn't it? But there is peace within my own inner world. Let me connect with my own inner world and feel the peace that God has already blessed me with. And when I can feel that, my behavior will be one that's based on peace and nonviolence. But also, as you begin to feel that same peace that comes from the one above, together we can create a world of love and peace. So all good wishes for a wonderful new year, but I hope it'll be a year that's blessed with peace in your heart and love in your heart for all humanity. All good wishes. Thank you.